on the day of your march and travelling, and on the day when you want to camp. وَمِنْ أَصْوَافِهَا وَأَوْبَارِهَا وَأَشْعَارِهَا أَسَاسًا وَمَتَعًا إِلَاهِينَ. And from their wool, now these three words, please note them. Wool from the sheep, this is aswaf, suf. The singular is suf, and the plural is aswaf. And that is the hair from the skin of the sheep. And then there are awbariha, they are the fur of camels. Number three, wa ash'ariha, hair of the goats. These are the three sources from which, you know, then they weave, and then they make the camp, you know, blankets, etc., etc. Asasan, mean these things, you make your furnishings, wa matan ilaheen, and enjoyment and using these things for a long period. Wallahu ja'ala lakum mimma khalaqa zilala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made for you shade out of which He has created. There is a tree, and it has a shade, and you can take rest in its shade. وَجَعْلَ لَكُمْ مِنَ الْجِبَالِ أَكْنَانًا. And in the mountains He has made for you places to hide, places to keep, to take refuge. If you know a big torrential rain is coming, and you are in some mountainous region, and you sit down in some cave, so this is the place for hiding, and this is the place of safety for you. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you trees which give shade to you. وَجَعْلَ لَكُمْ مِنَ الْجِبَالِ أَكْنَانًا. Then He has given you places to hide and rest in the mountains. وَجَعْلَ لَكُمْ سَرَابِيلَ تَقِيكُمْ. And He has given you coats which protect you from the warmth, the sun. وَسَرَابِيلَ تَقِيكُمْ بَاسَكُمْ. And coats which protect you during your war, when you are fighting. The armor. Armor Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because it was first made by Hazrat Dawood alayhi salatu wasalam. He was the first person to make this armor out of steel, out of, you know, iron. So Wallahu ja'ala lakum mimma khalaqa zilalan wa ja'ala lakum min al-jibali aknanan wa ja'ala lakum sarabila taqikum al-har wa sarabila taqikum ba'sakum kazalika yutimmu ni'matahu alaykum la'allakum tuslimun. In this way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is making and perfecting His blessings for you, so that you should surrender to Him. To Allah I surrender myself. Inni aslamtu wajhiya lilladhi fatara as-samawati wal arda hanifa. That is the purpose. You should understand these bounties, these mercies of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and in giving Him thanks, you should prostrate before Him, and you should obey Him. You should take Him as your master. فَإِن تَوَلَّوْا فَإِنَّمَا عَلَيْكَ الْبَلَاغُ الْمُبِينَ. Now, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, even after hearing all this, they turn their faces away. They go. They don't accept. Then on you is no responsibility except of conveying to them. Your work is done. You have recited these ayat to them. They have listened. Your work is done. Your responsibility is fulfilled. Now it is a matter between them and Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring to the book and will punish them. يَعْرِفُونَ نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ ثُمَّ يُنْكِرُونَهَا. They know and they acknowledge and recognize the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then they deny them. وَأَكْثَرُهُمُ الْكَافِرُونَ. And most of them are ungrateful, unthankful. وَيَوْمَ نَبْعَثُ مِنْ كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ شَهِيدًا. Now just recall the day when we shall raise from among every community a witness. This subject we have already read in Surah An-Nisa. فَكَيْفَ إِذَا جِهْنَا مِنْ كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ بِشَهِيدٍ وَجِهْنَا بِكَ عَلَىٰ هَاُولَاءِ شَهِيدًا. On the day of judgment, before individual accountability, there is going to be an accountability of the ummas, of the communities. And first of all, the messenger who was sent to that ummah, he will stand up and he will testify before Lord, O Allah, your message which came to me through Jibreel, I had conveyed to them. Now they are responsible. So this is, you know, a witnessing of the messengers of Allah against their people. Because now they have no excuse. They can't plead ignorance. They can't say, oh Allah, your message was not conveyed to us. They will testify. يَوْمَ نَبْعَثُ مِنْ كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ شَهِيدًا ثُمَّ لَا يُؤْذَنُ لِلَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا وَلَا هُمْ يُسْتَعْتَبُونَ. And then after that, these people who disbelieve, who have rejected the idea, rejected the faith and iman, then they will not be allowed, nor they will be given a chance to apologize. No apologies. Time has gone. No repenting over here, useful. وَإِذَا رَأَى الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا الْعَذَابِ. And when these evil doers will see the chastisement before their own eyes, فَلَا يُخَفَّفُ عَنْهُمْ وَلَا هُمْ يُنْذَرُونَ, then this chastisement will not be neither lightened for them, nor they will be respited. وَإِذَا رَأَى الَّذِينَ أَشْرَكُوا شُرَكَاهُمْ. It's very interesting scene now. When these people who were associating others with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who were committing shirk with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they will see those whom they thought that they are the partners with Allah. Maybe somebody, he spots, there is Shaykh Abdul Qadir Jilani. Or there is the saint, you know, for whom we had carved an idol. All the idols of Hazrat, the people of Hazrat Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam, were carved as representing the saints who had died. Or Ya Allah, they were the saints. They were good people. But after they died, they made, you know, the idols in their names. So now they see, there is the person, or that is the angel, which I used to worship. وَإِذَا رَأَى الَّذِينَ أَشْرَكُوا شُرَكَاءَهُمْ. When these people, mushrikeen, these people who were declaring somebody to be partner with Allah, when they will see their partners, قَالُوا رَبَّنَا هَا أُولَٰئِ شُرَكَاؤُنَا أَلَّذِينَ كُنَّا نَدْعُو مِن دُونِكَ. They will cry out, oh Allah, they are the shuraka, they are the partners whom we were worshipping along with you. فَأَلْقَوْا إِلَيْهِمُ الْقَوْلَ إِنَّكُمْ لَكَاذِبُونَ. But those saints or angels will retort back saying, you are lying. We don't know that you were worshipping us. You are liars. إِنَّكُمْ لَكَاذِبُونَ. وَأَلْقَوْا إِلَى اللَّهِ يَوْمَئِذٍ السَّلَمَ. And that day, they will offer all their submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَظَلَّ عَنْهُمْ مَا كَانُوا يَفْتَرُونَ. And whatever they had fabricated, that will go away from them. They have to be lost. الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا وَصَدُّوا عَنْ سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ زِدْنَاهُمْ عَذَابًا فَوْقَ الْعَذَابِ بِمَا كَانُوا يُفْسِدُونَ. Now there is another category. One is a kafir himself. And the other